Rick Byrd plays by the rules, graduates players, wins games. When Rick Byrd started coaching the Belmont men's basketball program at the NAIA level in 1986, he was also the school's athletic director, and, when short-staffed, he'd sell popcorn and soft drinks at the concession stand during women's games. It was a different world then, he laughingly tells USA Today. It's one he hasn't deviated from much as he's helped build the Bruins into a powerhouse mid-major program, reaching the postseason 11 of the last 12 seasons and winning 9 conference titles since 2006. Yet fifth-year senior point guard Austin Luke says it's Byrd's warmth and selflessness off the court that lead players to gravitate toward him. He once walked over a mile in the snow to get food for his players when the team bus was stranded on the interstate. And he refuses to be pictured in media guide covers or billboards in order to make his team's marketing player-focused. He also does things by the book that shows in Belmont's off-the-court statistics, which include the following. Every player under Byrd in the Division I era has earned his degree. His teams have held a GPA of 3.0 or higher for 17 consecutive seasons. Belmont leads the nation in academic All-Americans since 2001 with 15. Belmont has sported a perfect APR for 8 consecutive years, and the Bruins have lost only one scholarship player via transfer since 2003. We take no chances in who we recruit to come in here and represent our university, Byrd says. We recruit players for 4 years, not 1, 2, or 3. Other programs have different missions. Ours is to have quality student athletes. That's a choice that my assistant, coaches and I made in the recruiting process. We decided we weren't going to take any risks with Belmont's reputation on the line. By doing that, we found that it's made us better on the floor, because we have unselfish, self-motivated kids playing for each other. The best compliment we can get as coaches is for a player to tell his parents, it's exactly like they said it would be. As a pay-to-play scandal and ongoing FBI investigation in golf college basketball, Byrd could be considered rare in the one-and-done era. I think it's a bit different at the mid-major level, but for some of the bigger schools caught up in the investigation, I really don't understand it, Byrd says. I can't understand why anyone would want to win a conference championship or go to the NCAA tournament knowing they did things illegally to get there. But, I guess everybody's made different. Belmont has blossomed as a Division I program since it transitioned in 1996, reaching 7 NCAA tournaments, while joining the bigger Ohio Valley Conference in 2012 from the Atlantic Sun, but Byrd said he never considered sacrificing his integrity and Belmont's for the sake of winning. There are NCAA rules I don't agree with, but I'm certainly going to abide by them, he says. Speaking specifically about the scandal, to which federal prosecutors have referred to as an investigation into the underbelly of college athletics, Byrd is blunt in his assessment. I hope everybody, and I mean everybody, who did something wrong, is held accountable, he says. It's the only way to clean it up. But I also hope presidents and athletic directors are reprimanded too. Coaches responsible for all things within their program, but the people in charge of hiring the right people need to do a better job. Of the 5 active coaches ahead of Byrd in career wins, he has 754 wins at different levels: Mike Krzyzewski, Jim Boeheim, Bob Huggins, Roy Williams and Rick Pitino. Those coaches have utilized 188 future NBA players combined. Byrd has coached 1 New Orleans Pelicans Guardian Clark. Luke, the nation's returning assists leader and a preseason OVC first-teamer, says Byrd is one of a kind for several reasons. Basketball, he's been great. He's instilled confidence in me, and he's as good of an XS and OS coach as there is, Luke says of Byrd. But off the court, he's even better. In a sport where winning games gets magnified, he makes sure we carry ourselves the right way. He's a very special figure in our lives and in the sport, because he sets the standard for doing things the right way. Despite losing season scorer Evan Brads to graduation, the Bruins will once again be in the mix for the Ohio Valley's automatic bid to the NCAA tournament. but the ticket to the big dance has been frustratingly elusive the past two seasons. After winning the OVC's regular season and earning